So in this video, I'll be explaining the various components that this robot has, and this will allow you to understand how to operate this robot better. So we start with the frame. This is the basic frame of the robot, and you have three plates here. These three plates are where you have to place the food and essentials that you want to deliver. And then this entire robot will be placed on a track. At the bottom, you have the sensor panel. This is the set of sensors that we'll be using for following the line. So if you look at the line here, there is a combination of straight lines as well as a certain thicker regions, as well as again a straight line and some curves. So the objective of this robot is to follow this line. And then whenever there is a thicker part, we call that a node, and it stops at those particular thick points. Now when you are laying the track out, you will have to ensure that the thicker segments here are laid right next to where you want the robot to stop near the bed. So that's about the external setting. Now coming to this side, you have the control panel. The control panel is where you will be able to enter the commands that this robot will be following. So for manual action, to move the robot manually, you have a joystick option here. This is just to move the robot, and so that you can set the robot and align it with the line. So here you have a kill switch, and this is the main power switch. You have a keypad here, and this keypad is what you use in order to operate the robot and stop at various places in the room. So the way that this keypad works is as follows. You have two modes of operation. One is the manual mode and the other is the autonomous mode, where it moves by itself. The manual mode you use essentially for calibrating and aligning the robot with the track. So for activating the manual mode, you will have to press 0. And then to activate the autonomous mode, you will have to press A. And then once you are activated the autonomous mode, you will have to enter the room number that the bed number that you will have to deliver the food, followed by the letter D. D stands for done. So when you press D, then that particular number that you have entered gets registered. And the keypad is designed to accept up to 2-digit numbers. So if you have 3-digit numbers, then this needs to be reprogrammed. So once you have chosen the autonomous mode, press the bed number at which it needs to stop, and then press D for locking your entry. And then over here, you have an ultrasonic sensor, which is essentially used by the patient to confirm that he or she has taken the food from the robot. And this is a non-contact sensor, so we want to prevent any form of contact with the patient during this delivery. So once that patient has taken the food from one of the trays, then he places his arm on over the sensor here, and then that will trigger the robot to move to the next bed. And then we also have an override switch, so in case this is not working, then you can press this. So we have this essentially for control and debugging purposes from our end. And then on the bottom, you have a battery voltage indicator followed by the charger. So the charging port is here, and then you have to plug in the 12 volt charger. It runs and then you need to charge the battery until it reaches to 12.5. So do not charge this robot more than 12.5 volts. Okay. So that's about the various components of the robot. And now for the working. So in order to switch on the robot, hold and push and hold on the switch here. And then the way that you know that the robot is on is if the battery indicator is on, and also the sensors here will light up. Now if these two signs are there, then it means that this robot is switched on. Now once this is done, you can use either manual mode or autonomous mode. So mostly when you switch it on, this robot will be elsewhere. So you'll need to navigate it to the track that it needs to follow. So for doing so, press 0. And once you press 0, you can use the joystick on your right next to the power button for doing the operation manually. Here, this is forward, backward, left, right. And then once you align this robot to the track, you can then switch to the next mode. Now press A for switching to autonomous mode. Now once you are in autonomous mode, you will have the option to choose the various beds at which it needs to stop. In this track here, we have two nodes, so I'm going to make it stop at both nodes. So press 1 followed by D, press 2
followed by D. And then for sake of completion, here this control interface can take in at a maximum of 4 nodes at a time. Once you've given the inputs, the robot will automatically start moving.
Okay.
So this here, as you can see here, there is a thick line. And that thick line, as I explained before, is the node. So this is where the bed needs to be. So at this point, when it stops, the patient gets up from his bed. He comes, he takes his food. And once he's done taking his food, all he needs to do is place his arm over the sensor here. So placing it here will cause the robot to continue moving forward. And so the next node is encountered. And so again, because the keypad had the second node also in its entry, it stops here. So once again, since it stopped, the next bed patient will come. He takes his food out. And then once that is done, he places his arms over the sensor. The robot moves again. And then you can at any point press 0 and you will hear this long beep, and this means that the robot is back into manual mode, and then you can use the joystick to control it again.